This custom GPT creates emails that sound like me and make sales without me lifting a finger. Sort of. I still have to click send. But to create a custom GPT that delivers real-world results, I had to do something that most ChatGPT experts can hardly imagine: to deliberately sabotage my custom GPT. So why was this necessary? Let me ask you this. Do you want to know which the 7 critical errors are that make it impossible for your GPT to produce great results? The answer to this question would have saved me over 100 hours of failing to get my GPT to work. And as a bonus, I'm also going to reveal 2 mistakes that AI experts tell you to avoid that actually had no effect on my results. Mistake 1, not defining specific roles, skills, and context in your GPT instructions. So let's go into my sabotaged email writing assistant, into the instructions, and remove anything that has to do with your role and the skills, which is this part here. Although the difference in results with the sabotaged version, where I remove the roles and the skills and the context, is rather small, I would still consider it a mistake that you should avoid making. The second mistake is not using markdown formatting of your instructions. Now I'm going to remove all the markdown formatting elements, which are basically these things here. I was surprised by the results because removing the markdown formatting for my instructions didn't have any effect on the results at all. It produced in my sabotaged GPT a perfectly written email. Mistake number 3, not providing input-output examples to your custom GPT. In my custom instructions of my sabotaged GPT, I go to the input-output examples and I remove them. In this case, the GPT result of the sabotaged version has become significantly worse so that I wouldn't be able to use the email it produced. So it looks like providing input-output examples is a good idea. Mistake number 4, not mentioning your uploaded files in the custom instructions. So let's remove the file name. You see the uploaded file has this file name. And when I open my instructions, you see there's a section called uploaded files. Now, if I delete that, let's see what happens. At first glance, I wasn't sure if my GPT actually looked into the knowledge base of the uploaded files. But then when I asked it, it said yes, it did do so, and then it provided me a version that's more specifically tuned towards the examples that are in the uploaded knowledge files, which contains a collection of 50 emails. So it looks like whether you reference your file names in the instructions of your custom GPT has no difference. However, if I have multiple files, then it would perhaps make sense to still reference specifically the different file names in the custom GPT instructions. Mistake number 5 is not providing your GPT with enough knowledge. So I go to my custom GPT, I remove the 50 emails, and instead I upload a file with only 5 emails. Initially, I couldn't find the difference. The emails the GPT provided me with were actually quite usable. However, if I asked it, give me 5 more email ideas or write me 5 more emails, the quality starts to drop and I end up with the last email it gave me, which is something I couldn't really use. So the results actually really got worse. So the more knowledge you feed it, the better the output tends to get. Mistake number 6, uploading the wrong file types. So does it really make a difference whether I upload my email examples in a TXT file, in a PDF file, or in a .doc file? So while there wasn't a difference in results compared to the .docx file and the TXT file uploaded, the difference compared to the PDF file was dramatic. So I asked my GPT and it responded this.
I can read .docx, PDF, and TXT files effectively, however, retrieve instruction information is generally easy and more reliable from a .docx and TXT file compared to a PDF.
Mistake number 7, not outlining the specific tasks for your GPT in the GPT instructions. That's why in my original perfectly working custom GPT, I have a specific set of steps that I want my custom GPT to complete. So that's why in this case, I'm going to delete all of those steps. And the moment I start this GPT, I can already see the problem because it already starts to give me an email text, even though I haven't even given it my email topic. So the email it gave me is pretty much useless. And the second problem is that it didn't even look into the knowledge files I uploaded. So I have to specifically request that it looks into the knowledge files and find me email examples that work for my email topic. So if I don't provide my GPT with clear step-by-step tasks, then I have to do a lot of back and forth with it to get my desired result. Mistake number 8 is using the integrated GPT builder to try to come up with your instructions. The integrated GPT builder is supposed to help you come up with perfect instructions so you get your GPT to produce the output you want. To be honest, I was actually shocked at the results. I mean, the start was a little bit messy, but it got the job done. It actually produced an email that I could send to my list. But I have to admit, the first time I used this GPT builder to come up with my own instructions for my custom GPTs, it didn't work as well. The last mistake is perhaps the most overlooked: to provide your custom GPT with high quality and highly specific inputs. And yes, the difference between the generic input into my GPT and the highly specific input is quite dramatic, because my email writing assistant with the generic input produced an email that is pretty much useless. So to sum it up, you need to avoid these 7 mistakes. Number 1, define role and skills in your custom GPT instructions. Number 2, provide input-output examples. Number 3, specify the file name in your custom GPT instructions. Number 4, provide enough knowledge in your uploaded files. Number 5, upload effective file types. In terms of content-based files, upload .x or .txt file instead of PDFs. Number 6, list out the specific tasks that GPT needs to complete in your custom GPT instructions. Number 7, provide highly specific inputs to your custom GPT. If you want free access to the custom GPT email writing assistant that produces tangible results for me, then click the link in the description below this video to get free access. And if you found this video useful, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my new videos.